Welcome back. And after learning something about breadboards, it is now time to move on to power supply. Okay, so for that, I will have to first pause the video. I will have to set the orientation of camera, which is focused on the power supply. Okay, so this is the power supply module which we will be using. Let me just switch it on. And as of now, what you can see right over here is, let me just bring it closer. This shows 0.00, and here a little A is written, which means that this particular digital reading is for current, which is in amperes, and this shows 25.6. It means that this particular reading is in V for volts. Okay, there are few different channels. For example, you can, although it is not that much visible to you, like I have right now chosen for 30 volts, which is channel A, 0 to 30. Then you can select in between like 4 to 5 volts, which is channel B. For that, I have to connect my wires in between these two switches, in between these two connectors. So this is channel A, which is for 0 to 30. Then we have channel B, which is for 4 to 5 volts. And then we have from minus 15 to plus 15 with a 0, which is your channel C. So you can just connect it to plus 15. So now you can use it for 0 to plus 15. Then you can select for minus 15. So this is for 0 to minus 15. For this 5 volt supply, what you have to do is, this is the control of that. So let me just select 5 volt first. So right now what you see is this is 5.2 volts. As I told you that this is connected to B. My 5 volt supply is connected to B. Or jo B ki knob hai for controlling it is this. So I can control it and, you know, increase or decrease the voltages. So right now I want only 5 volts. You can see that this is set at 5 volts. Fine. So what we will do now is that this black wire will be at 0 voltages and this blue wire will be at 5 volts. And we will use these two wires, which will be drawing out from this, and we'll use this in my breadboard. But before that, I would like to introduce you with the functioning of multimeter. For that, again, I have to pause my video. But before pausing, you just remember one thing. In your course, you are going to use only 0 to 5 DC voltages, which means this particular portion. Once you have 0 to 5 volts, you don't have to do anything with the power supply. Okay, that's fine. Now we will check whether the voltages which we are getting are correct or not. That we can check using our multimeter or avometer. Okay, so this is the multimeter which we'll be using. And it will have almost three holes. Sometimes you can find more than three holes, but what you have to read is actually what is written on these holes. So very first thing is common. It means the black lead will go to this, which will be common. And be assured that for measuring voltages, and resistance, you should see these signs. You see, I hope you are able to see that. This is ohms, milliamperes, and voltages and diode. So you have to connect for measuring voltages the red lead to this side. Okay. And if you were to measure currents which are more than 10 amperes, I hope you can see right over here where it is. Yeah. So for that, you have to connect your red lead to this side. But for all of your experiments, you need only voltage readings, so therefore you will connect it only to the voltage side. Fine. And then you can turn on this multimeter. This can measure AC voltages, this can measure DC voltages, and also obviously the voltage or the readings of resistances as well as resistances, capacitances, and current. Right now we are only interested in knowing the voltage readings, and therefore you will connect or move this knob to a voltage which is just above the required voltage. So for example, if I connect it to 2 and my voltage on the power supply, as you can see, is 5. So if the voltage on power supply is 5 and I'm setting the upper limit of my multimeter to 2, then it won't work. Okay, so I have to just set the upper limit. Let me just set it. So right now what you see over here is this is 5.1 volts, and this is very important that while you are doing experiment, you don't have to just shake power supply or touch the main power supply or the main line. So point, otherwise you may get a nice electric shock. Okay, so our major thing is to measure the voltage right now. So first of all, I have connected or fixed my knob to 2 volt DC, and you can see that extremely this is that on connecting my probes, we call these pins as probes, black to black, red to red, and you can see it will show 1. 1 means an overload. 2 is more than 5.1. Sorry, 2 is less than 5.1. Obviously, I need to increase the overload capacity. So what will I do? I will simply rotate this knob. You see, I will simply rotate this knob and will bring it to the next high value, which is 20. 20 is the maximum capacity of our measuring device, and the voltage is 5.1, which is to be measured. So now let me just connect it as it is, black to black, red to red, and you can see the voltage over here. This is 5.15. Although in the power supply it shows 5.0, or it is fluctuating in between 0 and 1, but over here you can see that it is 5.15. So this is the exact voltage. Now you can simply adjust the knobs, and let me just place it over here, or let me just do it like this. Hope you are able to see this. This is the multimeter reading, this one. Let me just adjust the knobs so as to just make it 5. This is 5.13 right now. That's it. So we have got exactly 5 voltages. Now if I'll draw a black wire from here and red wire from this side, I will get 0 volts and 5 volts. So now you know some basics of when you will enter a lab physically. Sabse pehle, you will have to check there is power supply, and in power supply, the voltage range should be 0 to 5 volts. Okay, then you should have a multimeter with you, wires, wire cutters, ICs and breadboard. Ab hum dekhenge jo humne thodi der pehle sikha tha ki breadboard ke andar shorts aur open ya short circuit aur open circuit kaise hote. Okay, we will see to it.